When do you really hit your prime? A new survey from Australian seniors has found that the average age is about 81. The survey revealed that 3 out of 5 Aussies over 50 feel they've yet to hit their prime, and 1 in 3 Aussies says they feel happiest post 50, attributing it to being wiser and having more life experience.
Don't worry about him, Liz. He meant 51. And Liz Ellis happens to be that prime age, and she's with us now. Liz, 51, how does it feel?
I've got to say I'm used to it, but being in my 50s, I was really nervous about it. And when I hit 49, I walked away from netball commentary and we jumped in our caravan and drove around Australia. And by the time I got back, I had silver hair and no job, and I was really worried about what my 50s would hold. But I turned 50 and next minute I was on the project regularly and I was queen of the jungle. So the 50s are really suiting me.
Look, I'm not far behind you in age, but what about physically? How does it feel? I mean, I'm 42 and my back always hurts.
Oh, Sarah, everything always hurts, but you do get used to it, right? So maybe, like, you know, potentially you're not physically in your prime in your 50s, but your brain, like, you've sort of got that great experience. And, you know, for me, embracing my grey hair and understanding that I liked my body just the way it was, I think one of the things about when you're much younger, especially when you're a woman, is that, you know, there's always a flaw, there's always something wrong with your body, but now, you know, I have my cake and I eat lots of it too, and I don't care about what colour my hair is. So, you know, I think being in your 50s, it's something to embrace. And as my grandmother Bridie used to say to me, darling, getting old is better than the alternative.
Yes. Oh,
absolutely. Also, Liz, it's exciting news for me, 51. That means I've got almost 20 years till I hit my peak, so I'm feeling real good about this. So I know it'll get better. But this seems to be a fun new...
Sam, I thought you were at the opposite end and 15.
Well, no, that's better for me.
She's sassy.
I've got 45
at 51,
years.
Isn't she? She's sassy.
Anyway, there's a cool new attitude. I like it. Why do you think things are getting better for people over 50? Why now, do you think?
Well, I think all the baby boomers have got older, so there's lots of us, right? So there's so many more people over 50 than there ever used to be. So we've got a bit of a gang happening. So, you know, I'm not a boomer, but I'm sort of, I can see them from where I am. And, you know, they're showing us, you know, how to get old and how to stop caring and how to get out and have fun. So I also think that, you know, we know how to look after ourselves and... Come on, I'm giving the boomers some love, guys. Yeah, you've got to go with me on this. But we know how to look after ourselves, you know, and you do learn to embrace it. Like, it's heaps of fun.
Liz,
you wouldn't want to be in their 50s.
Liz, as the only person on the desk over 50, can I just tell you, it gets better and better and better.
Really?
The older you get.
Did you like 51?
Life has never been as good. I mean, when I was 51, I had 2 children, I was paying school fees, had to get up every day and go to work. Now I do bugger all.
Oh, Pricey, I hear you play a mean game of golf.
Well, that's where my handicap is, around 51.
Can confirm, I played with him. He's not lying.
Oh, Liz.
Liz, congratulations on being the peak age. If you believe Steve, it's not all downhill from here.
No.
So what is the peak age, Steve?
Big upside. Oh, 70?
70? All right. Oh. 19 years to go, Liz.
Wow. One to go for me.
Got so many years.
Thanks for the chat. Good to see you again.